people. Hello. It's so great to see everybody here tonight. So welcome to my graduation recital. I'm so glad that you are all here in person. Last year, I wasn't able to have an in-person audience, so seeing so many beautiful faces out in the crowd is making me so happy. So I wanted to talk a little bit about what my recital theme means. Uncommon sense over the last couple months of me prepping this recital, there have been people that are like, what the heck does that even mean? I don't get it. And it's kind of like an out there name and a theme. So the basic idea is that I'm taking traditional fiddle tunes, traditional fiddle ideas, and all of these things that we see commonly in old-time fiddle music, but making them a little different and kind of turning them upside on their head. And how I did this was I arranged songs rather than having a guitar or a piano back me up. I have trombones, saxophones, just percussion, and also having uncommon fiddle keys and unfriendly fiddle keys. You'll hear a couple of those later. The first song, it was a solo arrangement written by Mark O'Connor. It was a traditional song, The Midnight on the Water and Bonaparte's Retreat, and then went into Money Musk, which is a traditional fiddle tune. And I will be introducing my band a bit later, but this next tune is called Unknown and EVE Reel.
Thank you.
Oh my God, thank you so much. So I wanted to talk a little bit about why I have three fiddles on stage. It's a little excessive, yes, but they do have a purpose. So the first fiddle that I was playing on was actually my great-grandfather's, and my grandma I saw is here. Hi, Grandma. And she came all the way from Red Deer, and that's so cool. Thank you so much for coming. And this is her dad's fiddle, and I inherited it a couple of years ago when I started playing. I come from a long, long, long line of fiddle players, and I had a dream when I was about 10, 9 or 10 years old, where I was playing for my family, and it made everyone really, really happy, and because at that time in my life, most of the fiddle players had passed away, and music was our foundation, so it was starting to split a little bit, and you can totally tell that it really affected me because I listened to fiddle music my whole life, so not having it around was quite upsetting, to say the least. But because of this dream, I am here at McEwen now, and it's all because of those fiddle players that came before me. So I wanted to give a huge shout out to that fiddle on the my left, your right. Yeah. Thank you so much. Now this next fiddle that I'm about to play, John Arcand is a Métis fiddle player from Saskatchewan. Does anybody in the crowd know who John Arcand is? Yay! The Métis are in the house, awesome! I love it, it's so good to see. And John Arcand, he makes fiddles, and he is known as the grandfather of Métis fiddling, and he is the most decorated Métis fiddle player in all of Canada. It's just really cool. And the fiddle that I have is, I mess it up all the time. I think it's like 17 or 27. I can never remember. It's probably not even a 7 in there, honestly. I probably just made it up somewhere. It's an early fiddle, so that's the next tune that I'm going to play. That's the next fiddle I'm going to play on this next tune. Yeah. I'm going to stop talking. Fiddle. I was like, something sounds wrong. Please ignore me. I'm very nervous. I'm so sorry. We are I don't know if you could tell. That sounds better. The look of fear in both of your eyes, you're like, no, that's not it. Okay, ready? Thank you. this is the last time you're going to be hearing me talk for a little bit. Thank goodness, because I'm like, I have no idea what I'm saying when I'm talking. I'm like, anyway. sorry. Thanks for laughing. I think I'm funny sometimes. So I want to take a second to thank my band. There are, I think there's like 13 total people, including my amazing stage managers. I literally am gonna forget all of their names. Please take a look in your programs. I have them all there, and it was so fun getting to do a little photo shoot with them as well. It was so good. Over these 8 months, I've really grown a lot with these people, and over these 4 years, I've grown a lot as a human being, and having these connections with such amazing musicians is something that I will truly and forever be grateful for. And it's hard to believe that 4 years have gone by already. But not crying, I'm not crying, you are. You're crying, it's fine, everything's fine. So this next tune is called The Renewed Contract and Your Hair's on Fire. This is actually came up on my Apple Music like shuffle playlist, and I was like, man, this is bopping, I really like this. And fun fact, this was the tune that inspired this whole recital. I had a couple setbacks with themes at the beginning, and I was like, man, something's it's not connecting. I don't know what's going on. It's really hard to find people that play yee-haw music because, you know, no one likes to play yee-haw. But yee-haw is fun. I like it. But this song inspired this whole recital, so the band Crowfoot, they will never know who I am, but I am forever indebted to them for creating this song. Thank you.
Thank you.
To the last two songs of the night. I just want to take a couple seconds to thank a lot of people. First of all, I want to thank my family so much for being so supportive over the last, not only just 4 years, but my whole life. So it's been, I really appreciate your support. And, and just supporting me, even though I said, I want to be a musician, I don't know what to do. I'll figure it out. And they've been holding my hand along the way through the ups and downs. And those who knew me, I almost dropped out a couple times in first year. It was very close, but I stuck through. And another huge thank you to my bandmates, in specific, Mitchell, Jacob, Nathan, Liam, and you guys really helped me in first year. They were in my master class. And there was a few days where I would show up crying, and I would be crying in class, just like weeping a single tear down my face. And they would ask me, "Hey man, what's up? Are you good?" And I'm like, "No, not good. Everything sucks." But without them, I probably would have gave up by now. So huge thank you to them. Another huge thank you to my professors, Daniel Gervais and Craig Brennan, and Raymond Marie. They've helped me jump leaps and bounds as a musician, and without them, I wouldn't be half the person I am today. And in specific, Daniel, you have helped me so much, and I truly appreciate it. You're part of my family, and I really respect you so much. So thank you for all of your help over these 10 years of fiddle playing. A couple more thank yous. I want to thank Melanie Lapp for taking the time to come out this evening to take some photos, and the people behind the scenes. Mike, Tanner, I don't know your name, sorry, and the people doing the sound and the live streaming, it's so awesome. And then thank you to my amazing stage managers, Kate and Hannah. You guys have helped me so much, not only on the stage, but mentally and physically. I was in rehearsal earlier, and I was like, I'm going to throw up. I'm going to pass out. I'm going to die. Everything sucks. And they're like, you're good. You're okay. And I'm like, thank you. So it's been so great. And with these last couple songs, it's so crazy to think that 8 months of work just flew by in an hour, 45 minutes. And it's just very, very intense, because of COVID, a whole year was taken from all of us at McEwen. So it's really only felt like 2.5, 3 years of being here rather than 4. And I just really want to thank everyone for coming out again. This has been so great. And thank you so much to everyone for coming in person and making the drive from Red Deer. I know a lot of you. I really appreciate it. My Royals family, you guys are amazing. I'm going to stop talking because I'm going to cry. It's fine. Everything's fine. So Yeah, thank you again. And I hope you have enjoyed the songs. Here's the last couple. Thank you so much. And stick around, because there's another really great recital. Cam worked just as hard on his recital as mine, so please stick around. 8:45 is when his starts. Thank you so much. Encore! Encore!